This bike is run on the blockchain.
You ready?
I mean, the question is, are you ready?
But what does that even mean?
Hopefully we'll see him again. Just leaves.
I need to check this out for myself. New forms of transportation are taking over cities across the country. Electric bikes, scooters, hoverboards, you name it. And while it's great to have more options to get around, micromobility, the name for lower speed travel across shorter distances, has a bunch of issues. Why is that? Well, part of the reason is Americans love cars, and our cities are built for them. But these brothers from Germany grew up around two-wheelers and think that a new type of electric vehicle, one that takes the best features of a motorcycle and a bike, can improve two-wheeler adoption in American cities. Their secret ingredient? NFTs. This is a show about founders challenging the status quo. Getting around a major city like New York can be a lot. Bike sharing options are pretty good, but you can only get so far. I went to a tech incubator in Brooklyn to check out a new kind of electric bike company. First, I had to figure out where they were.
I'm lost. So this is the Pave. What is it?
It's essentially a fusion between motorcycle and bicycle. So we've taken the best attributes of an e-bike, so it's lightweight, intuitive, and then combined that with the good aspects of a motorcycle. So you still get that exhilarating and exciting feeling.
Electric motors have advanced a lot in recent years thanks to a growing demand for electric vehicles. Smaller, more powerful motors are allowing innovators to rethink what an electric vehicle can even look like.
The electric powertrains have developed so much over the past few years that really allow a lot more modularity. So you can really have a lot more freedom where you want to place some of the like key components, and that really allows a whole new set of design guidelines essentially that you can work with.
One of the benefits of electric two-wheelers is they don't rely on charging infrastructure.
And you just take the battery, close up the seat, and you're good to go.
It's pretty much on. That's smooth, smooth.
We've really designed it to be used within cities or like small suburban areas where the top speed doesn't go past 25 or 30 miles per hour.
Cool. So can we actually go ride this thing?
Yeah, let's try on a helmet and then let's go.
Oh, yeah, this fits.
Have you ever ridden, what's the experience with two-wheelers?
I know how to ride a bike and that's about it.
You ready?
The question is, are you ready?
Yeah, sit down and feel, see how you feel comfortable. Move around a little bit.
Do my stretches.
Yeah.
Warm up.
Exactly.
You gotta go this way. You gotta go that way. Okay. All right, so this is on.
Yeah, exactly.
Hopefully we'll see him again. Just leaves.
Woo! Yeah! Life is a highway.
Woo! As a first-time user, I was scared to ride pretty fast, but the crew rode it for the first time and did not hold back.
So how'd you like it?
It felt really good. I feel like when I first started, I was a little bit nervous at first, mm-hmm. but like once it starts going, it feels pretty intuitive. It kind of feels like a bike.
This thing rocks.
All right, so we got a two-wheel vehicle with a new design. Why is this innovative?
So aside from design and performance, Pave sets itself apart from a software perspective.
Using the blockchain, Nico and Casper created unique IDs, or NFTs, that are tied to each physical bike. They're trying to merge physical ownership with digital ownership.
So when you purchase a Pave bike, you get a digital version of it as well that you use to lock and unlock the bike. Looking at it more broadly, we're trying to create a decentralized mobility community.
The digital proof of ownership allows you to then rent out your bike directly to friends, family, or even strangers. Pave's goal is to create its own sharing community that's completely run by the bike owners. One of the issues with ride sharing is cluttering and a disregard for the vehicles. Maybe a peer-to-peer sharing option where people feel responsible to another human could help with that. We'll see.
I honestly think that the most optimal way to get around in a city is a two-wheeler.
simply because even if you electrify every single car in a city, you'll always deal with traffic and you'll always have to deal with finding parking.
In the most populated US metro areas, 48% of all car trips are less than 3 miles. If just a portion of these trips were replaced with sustainable EV options, it could change not only how we get around, but how we think about designing our cities.
Reducing cars in cities actually will open up more space to build more things for people actually living in the city rather than just parking spots with vehicles that aren't being used.
It's nice to imagine a city with less traffic, more pedestrian space, and a wide range of choices to get around. Electric two-wheelers won't be a one-size-fits-all solution to enhancing urban mobility, but they're an important part of the puzzle as our cities continue to develop and evolve. As for me, I think I'll probably take one of these over a city bike.